Good morning. This is the last slide, the last topic, problems part on abandoned block breaks. We have seen in the previous three videos, one is block breaks, another one is band breaks, okay? And we have seen the theory part, and this is the another one which gives two problems on band and block breaks. The advantage of block break as well as band break, both of them are incorporated in this particular break, that is band and block break. Here you require only one major equation, is like Tn by T naught is equal to 1 plus mu tan theta by 1 minus mu tan theta whole to the power of n. This is the only equation newly that it comes here. We'll see two problems on this, okay? Then we'll be finishing this problems on breaks. Then we'll move to the last topic, dynamometers. That is both theory, analysis, everything in another last video. Let us see one problem on this. So the problem is like this: a band and block break has 14 blocks. Each block subtends an angle of 14 degrees. Diameter of the drum is 750 mm and thickness of blocks is 65 mm. The two ends of the band are fixed to pins on lever at a distance of 50 and 210 mm from the fulcrum on the opposite sides. Determine the least force required to be applied at the lever at a distance of 600 mm from the fulcrum if the power absorbed by the blocks is 180 kilowatts at 175 rpm. The coefficient of friction between the blocks and band is 0.35. So the sketch may be given or may not be given. Okay. So I have incorporated the sketch here, and I have considered A is greater than B. When we discuss the theory part, you are aware of it. If A is greater than B, then force F should be applied in the downwards. And he has also not stated anything in the problem, either it is rotating clockwise or counterclockwise. So I have taken a case of clockwise so that the force required to apply the brake is minimum. Okay. So let us see how we proceed this problem. Okay. And what is the data given? Let us see first. So this is a band and block break with the blocks number are 14. So that is n is equal to 14 blocks. Then each subtends an angle of 14 degrees. In the theory, we have seen that is the angle total subtended by a block with the center is defined by 2 theta, that is given 14 degrees. Diameter of the drum is 750 mm. Diameter of the drum is 750 mm. And thickness of the block is 65 mm. The two ends of the band are fixed to the pins on a lever at a distance of 50 and 210 mm. So this is my assumption. He has not stated which one is 50, which one is 210. So I myself assume A is greater than B, and I take A is 210 mm and B is 50 mm. This is my assumption. Then the fulcrum of opposite sides, determine the least force required, F least, required to apply at the lever at a distance of 600 mm. The length of the lever between the pivot point to the force applied point is 600 mm. Okay, and the power it transmits is 180 kilowatts. And the speed is 175 rpm. And coefficient of friction mu is 0.35. This is the data. So my job is to find out the force F. Okay, so we are aware of one simple equation in belt drives. Okay, that is power is equal to difference of the tensions multiplied by the velocity. That is T, say here the total blocks are 14, T14 minus T naught into V, where V is the velocity. Okay, so the power is given in the problem 180 kilowatts, 180 into 10 power 3. Then T14 minus T naught, I don't know the value, I am just substituting this. Then what is the value of V? Pi d n by 60. So pi d, what is d? Diameter of the pulley. Of course, it also having two blocks, one on this side and on another one is on the other side. That is, if you look at this is the case, this is the pulley, and here there are blocks like this way. So this block thickness and this block thickness and this diameter is the overall total diameter, that is d plus 2t. So what is d? 750 mm, I write in meters. Okay, then 2 times of thickness, what is the thickness? 65 mm, that is 0.065. So this is pi d plus 2t, this is nothing but d plus 2t thickness. And n is given 175, that is 175 by 60. So this is equated to 180 into 10 power 3. By substituting this, by calculating, you get the value of T14 minus T10, which is 22,323 newton. This is the first part. Let me finish. What I did is, the power is given in the problem. So the power equation is known to me. That is the difference of the tensions of the extreme ends multiplied by the velocity. Power is given 180 kilowatts, 180 into 10 power 3. I don't know T14 and T naught. I have simply substituted it. Velocity is pi d n by 60. Diameter is 750. That is only pulley diameter. Then we have to consider these blocks, one on the left side, one on the right side. So d plus 2t, that is 0.75 plus 2 into 0.65, n is 175 by 60. By calculating, we get T14 minus T naught, the value 22,323 newton. This is the first part. Let me write, this is equation number 1. This is equation number 1. And one more relation we know, that is Tn by T naught is equal to 1 plus mu tan theta by 1 minus mu tan theta whole to the power of n. This is the basic equation which we have studied in the theory part. So in this case, last one is the 14th black, first one is the 0th one, 1 plus mu. What is the mu given in the problem? 0.35. 2 theta is given 14, so theta will be 7 degrees. 1 minus tan 7 degrees whole to the power of 14. So substitute this and get the relation. Then you get the relation between T14 and T naught is 3.334. You get this is 3.334. Okay, that is T14 is equal to 3.334 T naught. Let me call this is equation number 2. So I have two equations. One is equation number 1, T14 minus T naught is 22,323. Another one is T14 is 3.334 T naught. Now substitute the value of 2 in 1. So equation 2 value in equation 1, substitute in the equation 1. So I rewrite this T14 as 3.334 T naught minus T naught is equal to 22,323. Then it will be 2.334 T naught is equal to 22,323. Then just T naught will be 22,323 by 2.334. So that gives you the value of T14 is 31,000. Sorry, T naught. No? First, we have to get T naught. T naught is 9,564 Newton. So once you get T naught, then your T14 is equal to 3.334 T naught, that is 3.334 into 9564, which gives 31,887 Newtons. So I got the value of T14 and I got the value of T naught. Okay, then my requirement is force to be evaluated. So least force, when the least force comes, if your A, assume A is greater than B, okay, then least force requirement is clockwise rotation. So clockwise rotation. So applied force is downward. Applied force is downward. Then, so you can see the diagram. The diagram directly it indicates, okay, like applied force is downward, clockwise rotation. So if I draw the sketch for this, only the sketch for that is like this is, say a drum is here, clockwise rotation, this is A and this is B, okay, and this is the fulcrum point and this is the force point, this is we called L, and I have taken A is this and this is B, then if this is clockwise rotation, then this will be leaving side and this will be reaching side. Then you can say this force is T naught less tension and this is T14. Okay, then take moments at O. Moments at O. If you take moments at O, F and T14 both gives the same type of turning moment. So F into L, okay, then plus T14 into B is equal to T naught into A. So F into L, this is moments from here, F into L, okay, clockwise. T14 also causes clockwise, both are the same sense. Then T naught is in the opposite sense, that. So let me substitute my values. F, L is 600 mm plus T14, we got here 31,887. Then B, what is the value of B? 50 is equal to T naught. What is the T naught value? 9564. And A value is 210. Then by substituting this, you get the 600F is equal to 414090 newton. Then simply F, I need F. Okay, this gives F is 690 newton. F is 690 newton. Okay, so this is a problem, a straightforward problem, but you have to see what is asked. F least is possible when it is rotating clockwise and I have taken A is greater than B and this proceeds. My F least is 690 newton. So let us see the second problem. So this is also more or less similar to the previous problem, but here there are two more bits are added with the basic problem. Okay, so let us see what is given and what you are supposed to find out. A band and block break consists of 12 blocks. Each subtends an angle of 16 degrees with a drum diameter of 600 mm. The blocks are 75 mm thick. The drum and flywheel having a mass of 1800 kg and a combined radius of gyration of 600 mm. The two ends of the band are attached to pins on the opposite sides of the brake fulcrum at distance of 40 and 150 mm. If a force of 250 newtons is applied on the lever at a distance of 900 mm from the fulcrum, find the maximum braking torque, then angular retardation of the drum, and finally the time taken by the system to be stationary from the rated speed of 300 rpm. Coefficient of friction is 0.3. So this is a straightforward problem with a 3 bits. Let us first see what is given and what you are supposed to find out. The diagram may provide or may not be provided in the examination, but I have given the diagram with an assumption of A is greater than B, okay, and the clockwise rotation. This is my assumption. Okay, so let us see what it is given. Number of blocks. So number of blacks 12. Okay, number of blacks are 12. Then each subtends an angle of how much angle it is? 16 degrees. That is n is 12. 2 theta is 16 degrees. Then with a drum diameter of 600 mm and the thickness of the block is 75 mm, then the mass is 1800 kg. Radius of gyration K is 600 mm. K is 600 mm. Then the two ends of the band are attached on the block like 40 and 150. I take A is greater than B. A is like 150. B is 40 and the force applied is 250 newton, and at a distance of lever with 900 mm from the fulcrum. So the first bit is minimum braking, maximum braking torque TB max, and the second bit is angular retardation of the drum alpha, and the third bit is the time taken to the system to become stationary. Okay, so the coefficient of friction is 0.3, then speed is 300 rpm. So this is a straightforward problem. Just now we have used the one equation Tn by T naught. Same equation I use here. T12 by T naught is 1 plus mu tan theta by 1 minus mu tan theta whole to the power of n. So that is T12 by T naught is 1 plus 0.3 tan 6 by 1 minus 0.3 tan 6 whole to the power of number of blacks. N is 12. This. So with this, I get the relation between T12 and T naught, which is 2.75. By substituting, you get it is 2.75. Once we get this, then I take the moments, like taking this is the fulcrum point, this is A, and this is B. So this is F, and this is the lever length L. This is rotating clockwise. So leaving side is T naught, reaching side is T12. So we know the values of A, B, L, everything, and F is also known to me. Okay, so I will write moments. That is at point O, F and T12 will cause the same moments. That is F into L clockwise, then T12 into B also clockwise. Then this is anti-clockwise. So minus T naught A is 0. So now F is known, 250. And L, what is the L value? Length of the lever, let us see, 900 mm. So this is 900 plus T12. So there is a relation between T12 and T0. So you can see here, we can write T12 is equal to 2.75 T0. So in place of T12, I replace with 2.75 T0. Then this is 2.75 T0 into B. So what is my B? B value is 40 minus T0. A value is 150 is equal to 0. So I will get my T0 value by substituting this and evaluating. The value of T0 is 5636 newtons. Once I get my T0, then T12 is equal to, so 2.75 T0, that is 2.75 into 5636. So it gives 15,571 newtons. This is the T12 and T0 values. This is T0 and this is T12. So what is the first beat? Braking torque, that is TB, which is nothing but T12 minus T0 into D by 2, that is the radius. So here we have to consider the thickness of the blocks also. Then T12, 571, minus 5636 into D, that is 600 plus 2 times of the thickness of the blocks, 75 by radius, so diameter by 2, D by 2, this. So this gives in Newton mm, or else if you write into 10 power minus 3, you get in Newton meter. So this gives 3703 Newton meter. This is the first part, directly braking torque. Then the second part is, what is the angular acceleration? We know the braking torque, TB, can be written as I alpha, where I is the mass moment of inertia, alpha is the angular acceleration. So I can be written as mk square alpha. So TB value is already known. Substitute 3703. M is given mass. Where is the mass of flywheel? 1800. Not flywheel, brake drum. 1800 K. This is radius of gyration 600. Here left hand side I have substituted in Newton meter. So that also I will substitute in meters, that is 0.6 whole square into alpha. So 3703 is equal to 1800. So TB, okay, M K square alpha. Then I get the value of alpha 5.71 radians per second square. So that is acceleration, second part. Final part, how much time it takes to come to the rest. Okay, so what is the initial angular speed? Omega naught, that is 2 pi n by 60. So what is the n given in the problem? 300. 2 pi into 300 by 60. 2 pi into 300 by 60, which gives 31.4 radians per second. 31.4 radians per second. So when it comes to the rest, means what is the final velocity, angular velocity? The final angular velocity, the final angular velocity, omega final, will be 0. So that can be written as omega f is the initial angular velocity, okay, minus alpha t. Why I have written minus is, so it is retardation. When it comes to the rest, means it is going to be retarded. That's why I have taken alpha is negative. Okay, so this is omega f finally is 0. And initial value we got here 31.4. Then alpha already with us 5.71 t. So that is 5.71 t is equal to 31.4, or t is equal to 31.4 by 5.71. So it gives approximately around 5.5 seconds. 5.5 seconds. So it is a straightforward direct formula substituted problem. Okay. Part A is asked to find out braking torque maximum. Part B is angular acceleration or retardation, whatever it may be, alpha. Finally, the time takes to finish it or to come to the rest, which is obtained 5.5 seconds. Thank you.